Hey y'all, this is Coasters and Travels, and I'm back here at Fun Spot Kissimmee. I am back because everything is installed and the ride is open. It actually opened yesterday. I'm here to check out the finished product. Is it better than before? Let's find out. Okay, we're here at Mind Blower, but it does feel like they're open. I see people inside the station, but I have no idea what's going on. This ride is temporarily closed for maintenance. I guess it's down for whatever reason. So it looks like they're testing it now. So I was sitting here waiting for the train to dispatch and I see employees walking the track. So I'm guessing they're looking for something or they're training, I'm not sure. But yeah. Not sure when I'm gonna ride this because it looks like they're looking for something or I don't know. But we'll just have to wait and see. So I've been here for about over an hour and they still haven't opened the ride. So I'm gonna show you the parts that they did change. So the first thing they changed was the bottom of the first drop. You see the 208 retrack here. They changed it all the way up to the corkscrew. So the bottom part will be significantly smoother. They also made changes to the final turn. They added 208 retrack until the brake run, which was needed because that last turnaround was brutal. And this here is the final turn to the brake run. This is a better view of it from the back. All right, so after waiting for hours, it looks like this coaster is running with actual people. So it looks like I'm gonna finally get my chance to get my opinion on this ride. All right, the ride is officially open. I'm about to get my ride on right now. Okay, so immediate thoughts. Much better, much better. The shift from wood to steel back to wood was kind of jarring, I'm not gonna lie. But and the parts where it's rough is still rough. Like the second turnaround is still a bit rough, but nowhere near as bad as the first turnaround and the final turnaround, which has been converted to the retrack. So definitely a much better job. That was only the front row I've been in. I haven't did the back row, so I'm pretty sure it's even much rougher than that. But I'm gonna go again and check it out. Yo, I just got off the back row. That is significantly better than how it was before. Holy shit, this is a big difference. Yes, it's still rough. It's still bumpy in the parts they haven't done. But oh my God, it is so much better than before. I give it a thumbs up. Yeah, so I'm here with Dan from Midway Mayhem.
How you doing, guys?
Yeah, he was here taking pictures, and he rode this yesterday. So tell me what you thought about this ride.
So yesterday when I had a chance to ride, it was right around this time, actually. So it was hauling, and it still is today. You can just see the train flying around the course. I really enjoyed the improvements, actually. I think they did a good job. Some of the roughest part of the ride before the transition and transformation were addressed, and it's much better now. RMC has done a good job there. I still feel like a couple of the transitions from steel to wood and wood to steel, they're interesting.
Yeah.
Yeah, but overall, it's an improvement.
Yeah, awesome. I agree. It's a very good change. Very good change. I just got off my fifth ride, and it was in the second row. So the front row was good, the back row was good. The second row, it was a bit bumpy. It was a bit bumpier than the front row for sure. Yeah, this ride has definitely improved. The fact that I'm going back in line lets you know that they have definitely done a good job of, you know, the parts that they did fix. Now, arguably, you can say that they could have done the entire ride, to be honest with you. A lot of the turnarounds are still rough. A lot of the bottom parts of the airtime hills are still rough. There it goes, going up. But it's still a vast improvement. All right, so I just got off my sixth ride, and there's definitely a jolt like after the corkscrew, and then you go from wood to steel. That jolt is still there. I didn't feel it in the front row and the back row, but when I rolled row three, that's when I started feeling that jerk. I want to say super violent, but you can definitely sense it there. So it hasn't gone away completely. It's that transition from wood to steel and then steel to wood is still a bit on that first turnaround.
Later that night.
Okay, so I stayed here to get some night rides, and just to confirm my theory that the front and the back row are the smoothest, I just rode the back row first and then I rode the front row. Those are the two best seats in the ride. And it's nighttime and Mindblower is hauling ass. Holy crap. Those two rows are the best. The middle rows are the roughest. So if you are gonna come and ride this, make sure you ride the front or the back row. Okay, I'm leaving the park for real. And my final verdict, this was a good thing. They could have done more. Even though some of the transitions are janky, especially from that first turnaround, overall, this was a positive change. I wish they would have done more. I wish they would have honestly redone the whole ride. It would have been much better. However, what they did, it was a worthy change. And I rode it about 10 times because I wanted to get a good feel of, you know, the majority of the rows. And like I said before, the front and the back rows are the best rows, or they're the smoothest rows. They're the most bearable rows, I can say. The middle rows, you can feel it a lot more. But like I said, overall, the ride is a lot better. Is it worth coming to Fun Spot just to ride this ride? I don't think so, unless you're here for like another part, like for SeaWorld or Universal or Disney, then yeah, it's worth a shot. But anyway, that's going to end it for here. And if you like this video, make sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Hit the notification bell so you can get notified of my latest videos, and I'll see you later. Take care.